What's up, people? It's the Zigman, and I thank you for watching today's video, which I will be discussing my helium mining antenna, cables, and connector setup for my Bobcat 300. I'll also be showing you how to connect this installation to a grounding rod. Before I dive in, consider clicking the links in the description below, as they may help you out with what you may need. And if you find this information useful, consider clicking that notification bell, like, and subscribe button so that you're notified when I drop another video. I've got a rack 5.8 dBi antenna set up outside. It's mounted to a non-penetrating mast placed on a flat rooftop, while the miner is placed inside of the house. I've attached the antenna to the mast using a double mast clamp. There is an N-type male connector at the end of the rack antenna. I connected to the N-type female connector on my 8-foot LMR400 antenna cable. On the other end of this cable is an N-type male connector, which I plug into a lightning arrestor with two N-type female connections. This connector can be hard to crimp with a solid conductor, so I switch it with an 8-gauge terminal lug from Home Depot. This will give me a more secure connection. The purpose of the lightning arrestor is to protect the equipment in the event of an indirect lightning strike or other static electric energy. When potentially dangerous lightning strikes, an arrestor activates and diverts the lightning to the ground, where it will disperse harmlessly. Connected to the lightning arrestor is a 4-foot LMR400 Ultraflex antenna cable with an N-type male connector. This cable also has an RP-SMA male connector, which plugs into the back of the Bobcat 300. To protect the connectors from UV and water damage, I've wrapped them with a layer of Super 33 Plus electrical tape, then applied a layer of coax seal, followed by another layer of electrical tape. This will provide a long-lasting waterproof seal for my connectors. To ground the antenna, I've bonded a 10-gauge solid copper grounding wire to the terminal lug on the clamp that holds the antenna. This ground wire runs down the mast, which I've also bonded using another terminal lug. The wire continues until it reaches the lightning arrestor. It is recommended by the NEC to place the lightning arrestor near the point where the cable enters the house from the outside antenna. I bond the ground wire from the antenna to a ground wire coming from the arrestor using a split bulb connector. This ground wire will run from the arrestor down the side of the house and to the grounding rod. I finish by creating a bond between the copper ground wire and the grounding rod using a 1/2-inch ground clamp. This effectively grounds both the antenna and the antenna mast. With that being said, I'd love to hear your thoughts and opinions on my new setup. And if you found this information useful, consider clicking those notification bell, like, and subscribe buttons. Your feedback is what keeps this channel going, and it is greatly appreciated. So, stay invested. Happy holidays to you, and happy mining, my friends.